Hey guys, I'm going to show you how to build this video light for a GoPro camera. The interesting thing about this design is that it gets its power from the camera itself. There's no external battery pack. The power comes out of the bus connector on the back of the GoPro. When you turn the camera on, it turns the lights on automatically, and then when you turn the camera off, it shuts the lights off. I'll post a link up here to the demonstration and introduction video. That's got some interesting footage in it, and we'll get right into the build. Okay, real quick, I want to mention that this is a somewhat difficult project, depending on your skill level. There is a risk for messing up your GoPro, so be honest with yourself. If you're not up to doing some delicate soldering and stuff like that, you might not want to attempt it. I obviously cannot be held responsible for you ruining your own GoPro, so just evaluate that. Here's the light that I have mounted on the camera, and these are the lights that I have based it on. These lights are about $4 or $5 at like Lowe's. I've seen them in auto parts stores. They seem to be pretty easy to find. These are made by Utilitech. There's 24 LEDs here, and then there's 3 LEDs here. There's two styles. The older style seems to have these screws that attach to the back plate, and the new style has a section that just slides and then comes off. I've already taken the screws out of this one, and you can see it just pops off. From there, they're pretty similar, and I'm going to take one apart and show you what's inside. Okay, once you get these four screws out, the sides will separate, the top comes off, and you can pull out the circuit board with the LEDs. The older style has these three LEDs wired to a separate circuit board down here with two other wires. I used this style, the new style, when I built the light. It probably doesn't matter. They're pretty similar, and you can, I think you'll have a successful project depending or whichever one you use. So this piece is just a reflector, and you've got the four LEDs. Flip the board over, and the newer style has these three LEDs soldered on here. So what you do with the project is I unsoldered these LEDs and the wires, and then I unsoldered the switch and the resistor. So that just leaves you a board with 24 LEDs and this big resistor. And then you just cut off this section down here. I used a Dremel to cut it off. When you do that, you cut some of these circuit traces, so you will have to do some soldering. This is a different design that I was playing with, kind of a ring light. But you can see that when I cut the circle, it cuts the traces through here, so you need to solder wires on to reestablish those connections. Just for fun, here's another one that I've been messing with. Just has 10 LEDs on there. And here's another design. These LEDs are not soldered in there. I actually abandoned this in favor of the panel just for simplicity's sake. It was going to be pretty tough to solder all these on. But if you want to go this way, this is a round PCB kit from Radio Shack. It has several different sizes of PCBs, and this particular one works well with the GoPro. Anyway, once you cut this side of the board off, you just need to make sure that you reestablish your electrical connections. And a good way to test that is to use this base that has the three AAA batteries in it. You can just touch it on there and make sure the lights light up. If you are going to use less than 24 LEDs, you're going to need to adjust your resistor size. I'm not an expert in that, but there are equations that you can find on the internet to tell you what size resistor you need. So after you have cut this and soldered the wires back in that you need, keep in mind that the positive lead goes to the part of the circuit board that runs through the resistor first and then comes into the lights after that. And the negative will be on the other side. Again, you can test it with the base here, make sure the light works by itself, and then we can move on to mounting it and wiring it into the GoPro. After you got the light built and you're satisfied with the function of the light, then you need to mount it. I just bent up a piece of steel. I would have rather used aluminum just because it's a little lighter, but steel is what I had. You can see that the printed circuit board is attached to the piece of steel with little foam squares. Those are these squares. They're half inch by half inch by eighth inch thick, and it might be tough to see in there, but those squares make it so the back of the printed circuit board does not touch the metal. So it affixes it onto the bracket, but it doesn't electrically connect it to the metal. You don't want that. I've just got five little foam squares in there. This package was $5 and came from Hobby Lobby. After that, I just got a piece of Velcro on the bottom here and a piece of Velcro on the top of the frame, the GoPro frame. That's what I have it mounted on. I'm going to switch the Velcro out for this, these Scotch 3M brand. They're called dual lock strips. It's like Velcro, but both sides are these plastic tiny little prongs, and you squeeze them together like that, and I think it's going to be less movement of the light on top of the GoPro. But that's a change I haven't quite tested yet, but something that I've got in the works. After you got the light built and the bracket attached, the last piece of the equation is the bus connector to get power from the GoPro. Here's one that is unsoldered. You can tell that they are very small. I bought about six of these from chargeconverter.com, and I believe they're in Sweden. I could be mistaken, but it took about 9 days to get here to the U.S. These connectors are about $3 each. They're tiny and fragile. The pins on here are incredibly small. I bought the smallest connectors that I could find, and it's actually a little bit too small for my abilities. You can see that it'd be really tough to get wires soldered on there and out through the hole in the back of the connector. This is the other half of it. It goes on top like that. So I did buy one larger connector. That's the size, but it should be able to be easier to run wires in. So these are about $3 per connector. You should probably buy more than one because they're easy to mess up. The first one that I did, I accidentally soldered two of the pins together. So after that, what I did was I figured out what pins I needed, and I broke off the pins that were close to it. I'm not using all the pins, only using two of the 30 pins that are in here. So if you break off the ones that are close by, it's easier to solder to the pins standing by themselves. You can see that right here. There aren't any pins that are close to those. I'll put a link in the description to the pin out for the GoPro connector that will tell you what all these pins do. Make sure that you double check that with your particular model of camera. I don't know what GoPro is going to come out with in the future, so I won't know if this is going to work or if they change the pins. The bus connector has several different pins that you can get the ground from, but you want pin number 24. That's the pin that has power when the GoPro is on. And then when you turn it off, the power is taken away from pin 24 and turns the light off. Just for conversation's sake, pin 23 has power all the time, even if the camera is off. So I mean, you could use that, but that would run down your battery when the light is on. But it's just a little bit interesting. Anyway, when you solder these in, just make sure that you're only connecting to that one single pin. Make sure your solder does not run down into the connector, and you don't want to connect more than one pin together. It could cause damage to your GoPro. But anyway, it's a little complex project, but it's a lot of fun. I'm going to probably keep tweaking this and hopefully make the light better. Thank you guys for watching my videos, and make sure and let me know if you have questions on this.